Don't let her escape.
Carry me down to the street. Damien, it's Zoe.
Zoe, thank God. I'm so relieved to hear your voice. Are you okay? Where are you?
I don't know. I think Reza might be dead.
What? What did you find out?
I can't talk about it here. I just want to get as far away from this place as possible.
You can crash at my place tonight. There's not a lot of space, but be safe there.
Thanks. That sounds perfect. I could definitely use a shower and a change of clothes.
I'll try and guide you to a place where we can meet. The first thing you need to do is find the boardwalk.
It does sound as though the Azadi have plans with this tower, Aprilan, but I cannot see what that would be. They claim to shun magic, even though this technology of theirs relies on it. Maybe the tower is such a device, a magical machine.
Maybe it's a weapon. I got the sense that it was very important that they make their deadline.
From what little I know of the Azadi, they have never previously built such a thing, but it is possible. They have powerful thermaturgists, these Westlanders, and I suspect that their hostility to magic comes from their wish to control it, and their fear that others may know more about magic than they do. As for this place you discovered deep below us, this chamber of dreams.
I'm not sure that's the right word, but I don't know how else to describe it. I could hear the voices of thousands of people around me. I'm sure it's connected to the tower. The chamber appears to be located right below it, and the man I followed from the tower led me there.
This worries me, Aprilan. Dreams are powerful things. Combined with this Azadi machine, if that is what it is, it could have serious consequences. I shall send word to my blood sister in Irhad. She has connections in the strangest of places. Maybe she knows more. I would also have liked to see this chamber with my own eyes. Perhaps then I would understand more.
I tried going back through, but the rock's solid. There's half a mile of mountain between us and the caves. Without the portal, there's no way down there.
I will look at the wall in the cellar where you said the portal opened up. Perhaps I can learn how this musical magic works. I must say that I am intrigued. It reminds me a great deal of Banda magic. They sing to the earth to dig their tunnels. The Banda songs do not work on rock, but the magic could still be related.
Keep this under wraps, Naane. Don't let anyone get wind of what you're doing, not even Benrime. We don't know what we're dealing with yet.
Of course. I shall be cautious. Perhaps this is the opportunity we have been praying for, if we do not soon find a weakness in the Azadi front.
And we keep fighting them with the weapons we already have. What else can we do?
I am not suggesting we lay down our arms, Aprilan, but we are fast dwindling in numbers. Not a day goes by when someone is not killed, captured, and sent west to an unknown fate, or abandons the cause. We may soon need an alternative to force. There are many, we are few, and the Azadi support among the common people grows daily.
We're not dead yet, Naane, and it might be that this new information will help us. If that tower is as important as I suspect it is, we have a new target. I'll talk to some contacts, see what they know and what they've heard. Tell Bren and Chuan to get the remaining supplies on their own. They'll need to leave tomorrow evening as planned. We can't afford any delays.
Will you not go with them?
I haven't decided yet. It depends on what information I manage to dig up. If I get a lead, I'll have to follow it.
So be it. I may wait for you, but I will leave a message with Benrime if I, too, set course for home. May the stars guide you, Aprilan. We will see each other again soon. May the stars guide you and light your way, Aprilan.
Benrime?
Swordchild, did you find that person you were looking for last evening?
What? Oh, no, I... No.
What's the matter? You seem distracted.
I'm okay, Benrime.
All right. Well, the day is getting on. If there's anything you need, come see me.
Actually, Benrime, there is something. I'm confused.
About what, child?
I'm not sure what to do, and I would appreciate your advice.
I see. Well, child, I'll do the best I can, though I'm no wise woman. What's wrong?
I think something's going on, something potentially bad. Something involving the balance between the twin worlds.
Ah. Does this have anything to do with that nice young woman from Stark? Zoe, was it?
It may. It does, but I can't tell you all the details. I don't even understand what's going on. I'm just worried that I might be involved somehow.
I see, and you would prefer not to be involved.
I've done my share for the balance, and I have more pressing concerns. People depend on me.
Yes, they do, but that is no excuse.
I'm not looking for excuses. I'm looking for answers. I need to know what I'm supposed to do this time.
Such answers aren't always easy to come by, April. Often, we have to rely on faith alone to carry us through. Still, I understand that you want something more concrete than that, April. Very well. Here's my advice. You must speak with the Guardian of the Balance.
I've thought the same thing, but it's impossible. I can't shift anymore, and even if I could, the Guardian's realm is closed to me.
Maybe so, and maybe not. There is someone out there who might be able to help you.
Who?
An old friend of yours. The White of the Drake Kin. The White Dragon.
You're right. If anyone can help me contact the Guardian, it's her. But I don't know where she is. She vanished just after she was born.
You are April Ryan. I'm certain that someone in this city can help you locate her. Have faith in yourself and in the Balance.
I had faith once, Benrime. Look where it got me. What's left of the person I used to be?
I still see the same girl who walked through that door a decade past.
I'm not her anymore. I don't even remember what she was like. Now I'm just...
Well, I'll be damned. April Bloody Ryan. I can't believe it.
Who? Brian? Brian Westhouse?
The very same. God damn, I can't believe it's you. How the hell are you?
What are you doing here? I thought you were dead.
Likewise. You don't seem particularly pleased to see me again.
I'm surprised is all. Where have you been?
Oh, here and there. I've done a fair bit of traveling. Well, more than a fair bit, to be honest. I rarely stayed in one place for more than a month. I guess the Tyran invasion got me thinking about the world outside of Mercuria and life outside of the bottle. You could call it an awakening of sorts.
How did you manage to escape the Tyran?
Blind luck. First off, stupid critters didn't find my house, and a couple of days later, a dinghy passed by and I was spotted. The captain gave me passage all the way to Coruscant. From there on out, I hitched a ride. Why do I have this feeling you're interrogating me?
Because I am. I have to be careful, and bumping into you like this... It's easy to get paranoid and to be suspicious of coincidences. I don't believe in them.
I used to think that fate and destiny was a load of hogwash. But I know better now. There's a reason we met today, April Ryan. But I don't think you have anything to worry about. If I'm here for a reason, it's to help you.
So what are you doing at the Journeyman?
Just revisiting old haunts. And hoping to score a cup of Ben Rime's mulled wine, of course. How about yourself?
Same thing. I'm in the city for only a few days.
Well, even more fortuitous that we bumped into each other then.
So you've been traveling for the past decade?
I have, and I intend to keep traveling for the next decade or two, as long as I have my health. This world is fascinating.
You look so much better since the last time I met you. Younger, healthier, happier.
I do feel fantastic. I was bitter and angry back then. Angry at myself, at being stuck in this world. Now I don't see Arcadia as a prison anymore. I see it as an opportunity to grow and learn and experience. I'd forgotten why I crossed the divide in the first place. I wanted to go where few had gone, where there were still untrodden paths. Losing my home, being forced to run, it was certainly an awakening, and one I sorely needed.
Speaking of coincidences, maybe you can help me with something.
Absolutely. What do you need?
There's something going on, something that may be affecting both worlds.
Why, Ms. Ryan, you seem to get drawn into these things every time. Can you be any more specific?
It's more a feeling than anything else, so I need to confirm my suspicions. Or, preferably, disprove them. I need to speak with the Guardian.
Who better to tell you if anything's happening with the balance? So, why not just shift there?
I can't. I've lost the power to shift. But it was never that easy to get to the Guardian's realm in the first place. So to find the Guardian, I need a little help from someone else. The White Dragon.
Oh, yes. I'd imagine she could give you some pointers.
The problem is, I don't know where to find her. She could be anywhere.
Not so. I may know where to find her. I met a fellow traveler, a Dolmari from the Rose Court, actually, on a ship from Gien to Irhad not long ago. He told me he'd been to the Dark People's Library. Not many people are allowed there, and it was a great privilege. While he was there, however, he said that he was introduced to a pale, white-haired woman who introduced herself as the White of the Draikin. Now, I don't know if she's still there or how you'll get to the Dark People's City, but it should at least get you on the right path.
It does. Thank you, Brian. This is very helpful. It was good seeing you again. Are you staying long?
Another week, perhaps. Enough time to visit friends and... pick up some things that I can't get elsewhere in this world. Then it's off to sea again. I've been thinking about heading east, perhaps convincing a whale rider to take me along on a hunt.
Sounds exciting. Take care, Brian.
And you, Ms. Ryan. April. Now, I have business with the innkeeper. So, how about it, Ben Rime? Do you have a cup or four of your mulled wine to spare for an old drunkard?
As I remember it, Westhouse, you still owe me money on your tab from before the war.
My God, you have the memory of a stick man. Miss Salmon, I've honestly missed this place. Hell, you're probably right. I owed a lot of people money back then. Seeing as I'm still a bit short on cash, you'll have to add this to my tab, but I'm coming into some gold tomorrow. Old debts repaid, so I'll settle it then.
That'll be the day the Azadi decide to just up and leave. Money first, mulled wine after.
You're a tough woman, and I respect that. I have to tell you about this tavern I visited in a town near Altaban.